Speaking freedom. Speaking freedom. Giving you the answers to be free. Be free. Be free. 'Cause we're speaking freedom.
So, this is going to be kind of a throwaway video. I really don't have a lot to say. But I'm on my way to get my hibachi, so I wanted to do a video while I was in motion. So in height and light of the video, the song that just played. So the last few days I've just been thinking about my quote unquote dilemma. I say quote unquote because it's not really real, but it has the potential to be. And I say it's not really real because I can't touch it, feel it, and enjoy it the way I would want to if it was, you know what I'm saying, real. So, the kind of dilemma that I find myself kind of in, but not really directly in, is subjective, is that have somebody that you trying to work with, but it ain't really the time for y'all to work together yet? Not like it's not the time, but the circumstances surrounding the business that you want to do with a person, you kind of have to wait until their timing is right. You know, they always say right people, wrong time. And sometimes it happens in business, in relationships, growth, desiring education, like outside of what you are educated in, like to go to school, to have a baby, to get married. Sometimes you have to wait not until things are perfect, because sometimes things will never be perfect, but until things are aligned to where it's worth it. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I say aligned because sometimes, things just be haywire, and in the midst of things being haywire or a lot of things going on at once that you're trying to keep a hold on, it ends up being that that you try to, you know, keep in communication, keep contact, make sure that the connection stays fresh so that nobody else moves in on your business plan or your the thing that you're working to build or whatever the case may be. And you're trying to do everything to keep things on the up and up. But the other person at any time can decide to move on or decide that maybe, you know what, maybe this won't work out because of all the stipulations and all of the drama and trauma and, you know, the extracurricular things that go into making something work. And not, it's a difference between making it work, forcing something to work, and giving up it working. Just because something isn't easy doesn't mean it's not meant to work. However, making it work, I'll define making it work as actively doing things to increase a possibility and plausibility of something coming together and working in the best interest of those that's involved. Forcing it to work is being manipulative, lying, cheating, stealing, doing extracurricular shit that you wouldn't normally do, or that you shouldn't normally do. Because some people, all they do, all they ever done in their whole life is lie. All they ever done in their whole life is cheat. All they ever done, that's all they know to do. So it's hard for them to do something new because they ain't never did nothing else. They ain't never been exposed to nothing else. But those are people that have to force things to happen. Now, the difference between making things happen and forcing things to happen is when you force things to happen, it may not fit the way that you intend for it to fit. Versus when you make things happen, it's finding out how it fits versus assuming that it doesn't fit the first time that the thing, it doesn't fully align. Like, have you ever I am mom the builder in my house. I like to build things. I've always liked putting things together. I like painting. I like doing shit with my hands. I don't know why I like that. I just like that. It my mind is kind of complex. So putting things together, I used to take shit apart and then put it back together and figure out how to do it. And it gives me gratification, satisfaction. It gives me, you know what I'm saying? It makes me feel good when I am able to use my mind in that capacity. When I am able to put together creative, you know, videos or whatever, if I'm able to do like a stream of videos to tell a story, that also is like putting things together and giving me pleasure in on that level of things. So, now why was I saying that? So, when you do those things like that, I really can't remember why I was saying that. When you do things like that, those are things that naturally happen. So, I was saying that because when you start putting stuff together, sometimes you got a screw or a nut or a bolt that goes to a part. And if you don't line it up right, it'll seem like it doesn't fit. It'll seem like, man, they didn't gave me the wrong thing. It ain't no way it goes together. But sometimes you just got to make it work. You might have to shimmy it. You might have to take it, thread it backwards to get it to thread the correct way so that you can get aligned with the thread on the nut, bolt, or whatever it is that you're doing when you're building something. And when you're building your dreams, it's the same way. When you're building relationships, it's the same way. When you're building a business, it's the same way. Now, forcing it to work in this type of scenario would be you trying to force a screw that does not fit into a hole that it does not fit in. And instead of finding what fits, you try to force a fit, and when you force it, it messed the whole thing up. You know what I'm saying? So it's a difference with forcing something to work versus making something work. When you make something work, that means that you might have had a little time understanding how it works together or getting it to align properly just based on the circumstances that at hand for whatever it is that you got going on. But eventually, you was able to make it work as it was intended to work. Now, within that, you also have the something that's not meant to work. It ain't gonna fit, ain't gonna make work, ain't no way, no how. You know what I'm saying? Just stop. Don't even, you know what I'm saying? Fool with yourself like that. Don't get yourself hyped up on something that you know not gonna work. But then you also have when it flows. It's in the flow of alignment. Now, when you're talking about building, that may be when you put something together and the first time it just go in. The first time it tight the way up the way it's supposed to be tightened. The very first time it does everything, you know what I'm saying? It works exactly how the box say it's supposed to work. It fits together exactly how the box say it's supposed to fit together. And you know what I'm saying? So you don't have to really force it. You don't really have to make it work. All you got to do is put the two and two together and it's going to work the way it's supposed to work. You know what I'm saying? But depending on the manufacturer, depending on the product, depending on the user sometimes, and the user is the person that's putting it together or the person, the two people that's involved, will determine all of and the parts, because sometimes you might get something that's missing parts. Sometimes you might get something that it just don't fit together the way they say it's supposed to fit and something needs to be replaced. But that's how it is when you're building relationships. That's how it is when you're building business. So in some instances, like a dilemma that I'm in, it's like, okay, is it being forced to work? Is it being made to work? Is it easily working in the flow in which it was designed to come together to work? Or is it something that's totally not meant to work and you need to get new parts because it'll never work? You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's how the certain dilemma, well, one dilemma I'm facing currently. Well, not really facing. I'm not really in it. It's just something that's going on. What is you doing? You just in the goddamn way. It's something that's going on that is, again, it's very subjective. I could take it serious or I could not take it serious. What I can say is, in the midst of everything that I got going on, I really don't have time to feel any type of way, to be moved any type of way. It's just like, if it's not happening in real life, then I don't have time to pay it really any real attention, because I got real shit going on in real life that requires me to have my full focus, kind of, you know what I'm saying? Like, and when something requires you to have your full focus, then you gotta, you know what I'm saying, really focus. And so that's what I've been spending my time doing, is focusing on what I'm focusing on and trying to figure out what I'm gonna do next as far as content, and what I'm going to do as far as just so many things that have been thoughts in my mind that I just have not taken advantage of. It's still old goals. It's at least one old goal, maybe two, that I really need to look into completing. And I have no reason not to, you know what I'm saying? So I got a lot on my plate. But the main focus is, you know, the focus that is the priority right now. And, you know, there is nobody in my life outside of my home that is a priority. You know what I'm saying? Like, I grow disinterested. If shit ain't happening, if shit ain't goddamn going with the motherfucking flow and shit, if the shit is not goddamn working, I am not one of these people that would try to force a deal to work when it's not working. I am not going to try to manipulate, maneuver, or do anything extra to make something work, because if you got to do all of that, then it's not meant. Even if it was meant, once you start doing that, you change the rhythm in which God intended it to come about. If you got to manipulate your way in it, if you got to lie in it, you got to, you know what I'm saying, cheat, steal, all that, kill to get to where you trying to get to, then, you know what I'm saying, it at the end, it really won't be worth it, because it won't be as fulfilling as you believe it's going to be when you do it. You know what I'm saying? Everything looked like, oh, this is going to be fun, until you get into it. And then when you get into it, if you got it the wrong way, sometimes that will eat on you. But on top of getting something the wrong way, if you get something the wrong way, and then in addition to getting it the wrong way, the shit don't be what you wanted it to be, it's not as good as you expected, it's not what you prayed for, because of the way that it came about. Sometimes if you don't allow things to align on their own, you will mess it up. And sometimes if you don't do or move according to the alignment that the universe is setting before you, you will mess it up. This is why it is so important to really, 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 honestly, depend on God in a way that will make you move in a way that makes other people look at you crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to be able to move in crazy fucking faith in order to really be in alignment with God's assignment for your life and your soul. And you know, like, I just seen something crazy. This goddamn thing just did something weird. Anyway, it's not my car, it's just another car on the street, just bucked. Anyways, so that was a distraction. So, you know, like, instead of forcing it, if you force it, then you don't know if it was really meant to happen or not, because you made it happen, you forced it to happen. Even sometimes when you make it happen, you don't know if it was really gonna happen on its own or not, because you, you know what I'm saying, you made sure the shit happened. And it's a pleasant blessing. I don't really want to say a surprise, but it is a triumph when you're not expecting something to work and it just falls into your lap and it works, and it, you know what I'm saying, kind of catches you by surprise, because it's more than anything that you could have, you know what I'm saying, thought that could happen. Because if it was a matter of you doing it with your hand, you probably would not have made it happen. So the only way that something like this could happen is if God did it. See, and you got to leave room for that in the make it, made it happen, force it to happen, ain't supposed to happen, and then just flow with it. Because sometimes shit'll be a miracle or feel like a miracle because you don't, you can't put together how you overcame this, or how, you know what I'm saying, this didn't defeat you, or how you faced this and, you know what I'm saying, there was nothing, the water off a duck's back, you know what I'm saying, like. But when it's of, when it's from God, it should be like water off a duck's back. The only time that you really get to making things happen when it's of God and God is aligning it is when you are fighting what God is telling you versus what you know. Sometimes it's what God is telling you versus what you know versus what you're being shown. Because God could be telling you something. You could know what God is telling you, or you could know something else. And then it could be something else that you're seeing. So if God's telling you something, you know what God is telling you. Then somebody else is telling you something, you know what they is telling you. So you know what God is saying, you know what you know. And then, but what you see is something different. That's when you got to make yourself persevere beyond what you see. Now, listen, this is not easy for me. I am not the type of person that is going to force something to happen. So if you show me something, I'm going to take that for what it is, and I'm going to go about my business, and I'm not going to make a fuss about it. But you know what I'm saying? You're not going to have my attention like that if it's something that I am not, you know what I'm saying, okay with. If it's something that, and it's, listen, this is in business. This is with, you know what I'm saying, no matter what you are doing, I don't want to label it to be about any one thing. It's because it's about a mindset, really. Because once you, a lot of the things that I talk about, once you understand the mindset in which I am speaking of, and you begin to acclimate to the mindset, then you will begin to think along the mindset versus just hearing what's being said, versus just, you know what I'm saying, the surface level of things. When you get beyond the surface level of what you hear, and you think about the mindset and the concept of thinking in which you build, then you're opening up, it's almost like opening up heaven's door to more, because you are expanding. That might not have made sense to you. And if it didn't, that's okay. And if it did, praise God. You know, look, we're doing it. We got this. You know what I'm saying? It's just a matter of not forcing it and allowing it to happen in a way that where we can trust that it was meant to happen. Like some people be forced in the situations. I don't want to be forced into a situation, and I don't want anybody else to be forced in a situation. Some people be manipulated into situations. I don't want to be manipulated. I've been manipulated before, and it's not a good feeling. And I definitely don't want to make anybody else feel the way I felt when I felt like I was manipulated. So I don't want it by manipulation. I want it to where it just, again, it comes so like, oh man, that just had to be God. The doors just opened. The things just happened. Everything just worked. You could tell it was meant to be, because how did it happen so magically? And it not be any trickery. It don't be no extracurricular. It ain't me trying to send a message or me trying to, you know what I'm saying, get a point across. This is just how it flows in God's, you know what I'm saying, realm of alignment with your soul and your purpose, and really going after You know what I'm saying? What is worth it long term, bigger picture? You know, like, I hope that made sense, because I mean, this is really supposed to be a throwaway video, but I got to going and it was, you know what I'm saying, flowing. And then it was like, okay, we get them to knowing, and then they get to showing, and then they start doing, and then they become the best versions of themselves by what they're pursuing. And the things that they're pursuing is based on the information they got their mind to wondering, to think, if I applied this, how would it change not me? Don't do it to change you. Sometimes you do stuff to change your environment, to change your experiences. Because if you change your experiences, if you change your environment, eventually it'll change you. Now, the goal is to get into things that you're naturally attracted to get into things that you're naturally drawn to. So in order to get into things that you're naturally drawn to, you have to be a naturalist, most, you know what I'm saying, like, authentic version of yourself, or else you'll always be settling for things that you had to force, or things that you just, okay, well, I guess, because why not, you know what I'm saying, versus this is something that I'm passionate about, this is something that I'm interested in, this is something that I want to spend my lifetime investing in, you know what I'm saying, like, no short thrills. We in long-term deals, you know what I'm saying? We in long-term investables. And it ain't always money. Sometimes it's time. Sometimes it's education. Sometimes it's familiarization. Sometimes it's, you know what I'm saying, exposure. Sometimes it's something that you may not be thinking, but it's something that you need in order to get yourself and your life up to speed with your soul and the universe and what God sees for you. Because there are some things that God sees for you, and it's some things that God see for me that I can't wrap my mind around right now, that I would love for God to show me, explain to me, and take me in and hold me within it, and, you know what I'm saying, allow me to feel it so I know that it's real and authentic. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I know I am fully aware that there's some things that God want to do for me that I won't be able to receive until it's right there at my doorstep. So I always am open for the doors to open. You know what I'm saying? I'm open for the doors to open because I know there are some things that I won't grasp until I have it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it sound good. It's a lot of shit that sound good, but until you get it, until it's yours, until you experience, until you have that, been there, done that, you just won't get it. It won't hit the same. So, I don't even remember what this video was about initially, like, but this is where we are. And it's about growth. It's about not forcing things, but allowing things to happen authentically and organically. And sometimes for that to happen, you have to grow into your best self. You have to become better. You have to do some things in order for you to reap the benefits of the flow of God. This is about the flow of God. This needs to be called the flow of God, yo. Because you want to get in the flow. And within alignment, there's a flow. And within that alignment, you'll get everything that you need to know and everything that God want to show you. And then as long as you're doing that, you know what I'm saying, then you don't have to force it. If you ain't got to force it, then all you got to do is flow and align, and the things that will supposed to be will be in a matter of time. I hope that makes sense. This was about alignment. This was about flowing, not forcing. Making things happen, if everything is in alignment and that's what it came with, and you know that that's what, how it's supposed to go, but not forcing it. You know what I'm saying? We're not forcing shit. If it ain't meant to be, goddamn, then it was nice knowing you. It was nice having the conversation. It was nice to, you know, think about it. It was nice to consider it. But if it's really, truly not meant to be, then I don't want to force anything. I want to be in alignment with what God has for me. Basically, only, completely, wholly. You know what I'm saying? I'm waiting for God to show me, hold me, so I can know that he know me. Okay. So, basically, I am where I'm going at, so I gotta go. But you know how this story go. And we in the flow. And I'ma always tell you what you need to know. I'ma always help you grow as much as possible. But if you don't listen, then that's on you. I'm only doing what I'm supposed to do.
Your non-winning cash box. No vomit. He's daunting. Them show me love, show me love, show me love. Now we have these things wanted. Hard times, wait for it, and then she break for it. Love don't cost a thing, ashamed how much I pay for it. Love don't cost a thing, ashamed how much I gave for it. Heartbroken into pieces, but tape on it. Fragile, made out of glass, close that drapes on it. Trust issues, so deep, play it safe on it. Will I ever love again, or will I stay lonely?
Speaking Freedom presents Good Head Group, providing advanced spiritual studies and personal developmental insight, brought to you by Love Gang and Speaking Freedom. We look forward to helping you grow in all the areas of your life. We hope that you find all the information needed for your growth. God bless. Please listen to all disclaimers provided. If you are currently under physician's care, please maintain that relationship. This is not intended to stop your current treatment plan. If you need physician care, please seek out medical attention. Please note, all results are based on the individual's ability to adapt and adjust to any given environment and situation. We are not responsible for your results at Speaking Freedom. The Life Enhancement Coaches at Speaking Freedom provide information to help you grow. You are responsible for maintaining that growth, taking on and then applying the information to your individual life as you deem needed and necessary. This may contain and explain explicit content. Please use parental discretion. For best results, you will need an open mind, the ability to research, and a balanced lifestyle.
Please join us daily for your inspiration and motivation.
We have the entire world to offer you at your fingertips. Your Life Enhancement Coaching Specialist. Thank you for choosing us to assist you in accomplishing your personal and professional goals. And have a beautiful day. In love, we trust. This is brought to you by Good Head Group, Love Gang, and Speaking Freedom. We thank God for you, and we love you.
Hi, I'm Kaci. Dr. Kaci, to be exact, owner of Speaking Freedom LLC, Love Gang, and Good Head Group LLC. I am also a certified life coach and host of Speaking Freedom Radio and TV. Although I have recently became an ordained minister, please be aware that I am still me, raw and uncut, the way God made me and allowed life to shape me. I pray and expect God to use me for people who can receive the way I communicate, as well as my delivery. I am not for those who are already saved, religious, or super deep. I am for the leaders, hustlers, and street influencers around the world, including pimps, killers, drug dealers, and working girls. I am sharing my experiences and perspective to help someone be inspired to be better. And for those who can identify with the various aspects of my mindset. My mindset alone does not determine the status of any active connections or current relationships that have not already been specifically addressed. Additionally, these recordings should not be taken personally if I have not already spoken to you about the topic or expressed that I have an issue. These recordings are a part of my life's work to document my experience, perspective, and to see how life has shaped me. My plan in using my stories publicly and socially is to encourage growth in those who can identify with the experiences and find inspiration in my life to heal and overcome the path that they've been set on, no matter what they face, as according to the purpose of their soul, until healing takes place. Despite the experiences that I may have had with any person, sometimes known and unknown, I hold no grudges, no hate, no bitterness, or any other ill feelings against anyone. I pray that your life is whole and very fruitful. I forgive you, as I hope that you forgive me if I have wronged you or anyone that you know or anyone who listens to me. I pray that you have peace and extend the same grace to others. I have love for everyone, especially on a human level, despite flaws or experiences. But that doesn't mean that I will associate or be close to every human that I know or meet. I've experienced a very eventful life and truly believe that my mindset and story based on experiences could help those who identify with how I think and are looking for inspiration to grow further, go beyond hurt, and be great. I pray that these recordings bless you and your soul in every way and whatever way God has intended. Sending love and light to all. Thanks for listening. Achieve your dreams.